Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how I turned this oversized Lakers jersey. Into this laced up fitted dress that I took my birthday pictures in because your girl just turned 24. Ooh child, I'm getting old. But this is also beginner friendly. This has no sewing in it whatsoever. So let's get into it. So basically, I use this dress out of my closet for the outline, and I like how this dress fits on me personally, so that's why I just used this dress. And as I started cutting, I didn't cut exactly on the dress, like the outline of the black dress. I cut a half an inch off for the seam allowance. You don't want to cut too close, because then it's going to be way too tight. And it's not gonna be comfortable. I mean, unless you just want it to be that tight. But hey, everybody, you know, to each his own. Everybody like what they like. And after cutting out both sides, this is how it turned out. After cutting it out, you can leave it like that and actually start putting the eyelets in. But if you're someone like me and you want the sides to look a little more neat without having to sew, you can use peeling stick or a heating bun. As you can see, I'm folding the sides down and I'm making my crease. So once I get ready to use my peeling stick, it'll be easier for me because I have a guide based off of the line that I created. Once you get done making your crease, grab the peeling stick, and then we already created the guide for it, which is that line. You just roll it out along that line and cut it. And then after you cut it, you fold it back over, you grab your iron, and then you start ironing it onto the jersey. And then once you iron that side, the tape side that you still see, you peel that part off. And then after you peel that part off, you fold the side back over and you start ironing again to make sure you're bonding the fabrics together. Once you peel that tape off though, it's gonna be sticky and it's gonna stick. So make sure you work in this section so you don't mess anything up. And also, I don't want to feel like I'm stealing someone else's work, because that's not the type of person I am. So this idea I actually got from Kiyomani Stevenson, and I'm going to have the link to her video of the dress that she did in my description box. So make sure y'all check out how she did hers as well, because that's where I got my inspiration from. After I did all four sides, this is how it turned out. As you can see, it looks a lot neater than how it did when you just cut it out and didn't do anything to the sides. It looks better. Now for the fun part. This is what I use to lace up the sides. I found this in the hardware section. They have different colors. I wanted purple, but they didn't have it, so I got white instead. These are some 1/4 eyelets. They didn't have many of these, so I ended up grabbing some 7/16, but those are way too big, so I ended up not using them at all. Then these are the eyelet tools. This is what you use to actually put the eyelets on the dress and put them together. And then you use a hammer for that. I don't really remember how many eyelets actually come in a box. I think it's 15, but I used 11 on each side. So I used 44 in total on the whole dress. And I just grabbed a Sharpie. I marked where I wanted the eyelets to be. I moved the eyelets out the way. I grabbed I can't even think of what the thing called. But it's like, a seam ripper. I think that's what it's called, a seam ripper. I use it on my jeans most of the time when I'm trying to fix my jeans. But I just grabbed the seam ripper and started poking the holes in, and I started to put my eyelets on. Also, these eyelets have a top and they have a bottom. Make sure you're using the right side. So this part is the bottom part. As you can see, it's wider on the outside. That is the top part, it's smaller. So please make sure you're putting it on the right side. And also, when you're making the hole for these, don't make the hole too big, or it's just not gonna stay on there. So once you get it on there, you grab the eyelet tool. The eyelet tool has a top and a bottom. So the bottom part is that little black part that I just laid the jersey on top of. That top part is that part that look kind of like a bolt. And what you do is you line it up on top of it. You grab the hammer and you hammer it in there together. And that's how it's gonna look when you finish. And this is how it turned out when I did all four sides. Now all you have left to do is lace it up on the sides, and I laced it up just how you would lace up your shoes. And also, shout out to the Lakers fans out there. I'm a Lakers fan as well. Rest in heaven, Kobe. And this just turned out so bomb. Thank y'all for watching my video. See y'all in my next one.